Change of strategy set in motion by the death of a 13-year-old SCPA student, Esme Kenny. News 5's Brian Hamrick has more on the new emergency plan. Brian?
Yeah, Jack, today was the first day for a new police training program. And what makes this different is it was created out of one tragedy, hoping to prevent another. We know the name Esme Kenny as the 13-year-old murder victim. But now,
Esme itself stands for Emergency Search for Missing or Endangered.
Esme is also an acronym for the newest police program to help find missing people, inspired by Esme Kenny.
Esme was a very physical person, and we can't have her back physically, but I think we try and really try and breathe her spirit into our heart and her sense of community.
Esme's parents, Tom and Lisa Kenny, asked Cincinnati police to review their missing persons procedures, all after what happened in March. Esme was reported missing and found murdered in a wooded area near her home. Convicted sex offender Anthony Kirkland is charged.
If we can save one life, we will have accomplished something really important.
Police began training today. The basic idea is to enhance the thought process in the field. Now officers have a checklist to review. They're learning more about outside help available, like the urban search and rescue team, canine units, and computer specialists.
What we've tried to do is create a comprehensive, holistic approach, actually, to this type of an incident.
Officers are wearing a pin that says Esme. Now, more than the name of a victim, an approach to helping find the missing.
There isn't any doubt that all of us would trade all this stuff in a heartbeat to have her back, but we can't have that, so we're doing the best we can.
So the officers who have this training will be called on to respond when there is any missing person report. And police tell us there are about 1,500 of these reports in Cincinnati every year. Cherie?